you guys, today we will start with what? What we left last time, what we talked about last time, what concept we talked about last time. The last point of the Monday lecture was what? Renin.
Angiotensin.
Angiotensin.
Aldosterone.
Aldosterone system. We didn't draw a diagram, we just talked about principle. We talked about the renin converts what?
Converts angiotensinogen.
And angiotensinogen to what?
Angiotensin
1. And then, what next steps to the stage?
ACE
enzyme to convert what into what? Why do we need all these problems with release of renin eventually to stimulate and create angiotensin 2? What's angiotensin doing? How? He has angiotensin 2 increases blood pressure by two ways. The first way is what?
Increasing water reabsorption.
No, it's not him, somebody else. He's telling somebody else to be released.
Acting on the adrenal cortex to release aldosterone.
It means we need angiotensin 2 to be present to stimulate release of aldosterone from adrenal cortex. It means he needs a help from aldosterone. Why release of aldosterone will increase your blood pressure? What's the mechanism? What aldosterone is doing? Actually, your thought, don't forget your thought. What aldosterone is doing?
Helping to increase the blood pressure by increasing water retention.
Yes, increasing retention or reabsorption of water. Why increase the volume of blood, increasing blood pressure? Because if you have more water, you increase the volume of the blood, and how you increase the blood pressure. But it's not enough, and what else angiotensin 2 is doing directly? He is a powerful whom? Vasoconstrictor. You vasoconstrict the entire circulatory system, you increase your blood pressure. It means we got this concept, which is quite non-trivial. Now let's do the diagram. All organs of the entire body which involved in this renin, angiotensin, aldosterone game to increase your blood pressure. The first organ, obviously, which involved in this complex relationship is your circulatory system. And I put it as a donut. Red donut, this your number one, and here I will put a list of organs which involved in renin angiotensin aldosterone system stimulation. Renin, angiotensin, aldosterone system. The first one is your, how I put it here, circulatory system. Let me see. What happened? You have a patient who has a wound here, and the patient starts losing the blood. Due to wound. Losing the blood immediately decreases this patient's blood pressure, which causes decrease of the blood pressure. BP stands for blood pressure here today. It means if your patient losing the blood due to wound, it's losing its blood pressure. Immediately, part of the 20% of circulation goes to the kidney, right? It means immediately this bean-shaped organ, you have your blood going to the kidney, it's your renal perfusion. If you have your blood pressure low or down or decreased, what happened to the renal perfusion? It goes up, down, or no change?
Decreases.
You have your systemic circulation blood pressure goes down due to the losing blood by this patient. What happened to renal perfusion? Up, down, or no change? Down. How many people believe it's down? That's correct. It means you have low blood pressure in the general circulation, you have low blood pressure in every part of your body, including your renal perfusion. And you know what? This kidney, which is second organ, plays a huge role in renin, angiotensin aldosterone system activation. It's your kidneys. You have two of them. Immediately, it has a special sensors. Kidney has a sensors for the low blood pressure. As soon as kidney sensing low blood pressure, because renal perfusion is down, it starts releasing into the blood, which leaving the kidney, start releasing renin. Renin released in the kidney upon kidney sensing low blood pressure, low sensing renal, low renal perfusion. It means as soon as you have low renal perfusion, low blood pressure, you start releasing renin. This is your renin. Before, at normal blood pressure or high blood pressure, you do not have renin release because these sensors only sensing low blood pressure. And this renin start going back to your general circulation, and now in your blood you have this very active enzyme, renin. Renin substrate is actually released by whom? We mentioned last time. Who releasing substrate for renin every time at a normal healthy situation? Who is this guy? Kidney? No, we're done with kidney. Should be something else now into play. Who is releasing substrate for renin every single minute? Then it's normal.
The lip.
The liver. That's right. It means here you have your liver. It's number three player in this complex story. It's the liver. Liver releasing its hepatocytes, special cells releasing special substrate, which is angiotensinogen. Ten amino acid long, non-active enzyme. And how we, let's do abbreviation, ATG. Released here, let me draw it larger, this donut. Means your angiotensinogen is always released, always present. It means as soon as really renin is released by the kidney in response to low blood pressure, it immediately will find its substrate. The substrate for renin is angiotensinogen. What it's doing, this 10 amino acid, quite long, non-active enzyme, renin simply cut. What's enzyme doing? Enzymes are cutters. Cutters of the protein on the specific amino acid sequences, right? It means renin also a cutter, an enzyme which cuts two amino acids from angiotensinogen and makes it angiotensin 1, which is 8 amino acids. Now we have this angiotensin 1 in the circulatory system. And this blood goes through the special organs, which has a expression on its capillary special ACE enzyme, which is angiotensin converting enzyme. Who is this organ?
Lungs.
The lungs, that's right. Here we have next player for this game. This is your lungs. And lungs has here expressed all the time very aggressive enzyme ACE. On the endothelial cells, of the pulmonary capillaries, we have ACE. Lungs, they have ACE, which is angiotensin converting enzyme. Somebody mentioned last time that ACE inhibitors you give your patients to rebuttal high blood pressure is one of the many, many tools available. Liver secreted angiotensinogen, abbreviation for angiotensinogen ATG. 10 amino acid non-active. Kidneys release renin. Circulatory